And today I'm doing a pretty awesome video if you ask me, because it is a collaboration video with one of my really awesome YouTube friends, Bianca. Bianca B loves you here on YouTube, and if you don't know who I'm talking about, you're seriously living under a rock. For real, because she's awesome, she's amazing, and I remember when I first started my channel and I was watching Bianca's videos and she was such a huge inspiration. She was a beauty smartie for 17 and I was like, oh my god, I want to be one of those one day. And
look at me now, look at me now, oh.
No, but seriously, when I found out she even watched my videos, I completely spazzed out, and this was a few months ago, and she emailed me, she wanted to do a collab, so I was like, hey, let's do it. So today we are going to be doing our 10, well, I'm doing 10, I don't know how many she's doing, she's a lip freak, so I'm pretty sure she may go over. If not, then it's 10 spring lippies, 10 favorite, 10 must-have spring lippies, whatever, that's what I'm calling mine. Whatever she calls hers is what she calls hers. So, without further ado, we're gonna get into it because I'm acting like a complete fool.
No.
Yeah, I am. So, let's go. Now.
Okay.
We're gonna start, what should I start with? Let's see. We're gonna start with one of my favorite drugstore brands, and that is CoverGirl. Basically, this is what the bad boy looks like. I'm pretty horrible at describing lipstick colors or just colors in general, so bear with me. But basically, how I can describe it just by looking at it in a tube, it is a mauvey pinkish purple. Makes sense? Yeah. And basically, this is what the color looks like. So as you can see, it's like a mauvey tone, pinkish purple kind of thing. And it is in the shade called Delicious 323. It's a phenomenal lip color. I really, really like it. Very everyday for me. It doesn't wash my lips out. And it's also very hydrating and moisturizing. I absolutely despise lipsticks that pull all the moisture out of my lips and just make it very crusty and things like that. But then again, even though I hate that aspect of lipsticks, that doesn't stop me from wearing those kind of lipsticks if the color is cute. Next up is Maybelline, and Maybelline has some of the most vibrant and pigmented lipsticks out there in the drugstore right now. Haven't seen any other brand compare to these lipsticks, and I'm talking about the Maybelline Vivids that come in this orangey neon tube. Absolutely love them. When they launched last year, I had to grab every single one because I'm a lip junkie and I have to have every color in the collection if I love it, especially if they're bright and vibrant and just as great as these are. Basically, the first one I'm going to talk about is Hot Plum. Super duper gorgeous color. It is a plum, but it's more on the brighter side. And basically, this is what it looks like. As you can see, it's very, very pigmented, vibrant. You can build this up or you can wear it out sheer. I really like to wear this one out sheer just for the simple fact that I don't really go full on plum unless it's like bam in your face, and I just always wear this one sheared out. I don't know why, but that's the way I like to wear it in the springtime. And then this next one is Shocking Coral. The name describes it perfectly. It's this really pretty kind of like punch of coral. I absolutely love it. I wear it straight, full on straight from the tube. I don't sheer it out. I just absolutely love the way this looks. It's very flattering on my skin tone. And if you have a darker skin tone, I feel like this is going to work perfect. And it's just awesome. Both lipsticks are very hydrating and moisturizing, and they aren't gonna dry your lips out, which is a plus for me. Of course, I have to wear one of my top favorite spring lipsticks all throughout the video, and it is the lipstick I'm wearing right now. If you guys were curious, the name is MAC Kinda Sexy. Recently picked this up, and it has just become my holy grail every single day lipstick. It's just that pretty. I can describe it as being kind of like a rosy pinkish nude. That's how I would describe it. If you don't have this, you need this in your life. Like, I'm not even gonna lie to you, you need it. It's not a, oh, should I get it? No. Girl, you need it. Go get it right now. And it is a matte lipstick, which is kind of weird because normally when I think of matte lipsticks, I think of full-on Ruby Woo. Like, Ruby Woo is the most over-drying lipstick, but it's beautiful, I have ever worn, and it's extremely uncomfortable on my lips, but it's really pretty. I love that lipstick, but the only thing I hate about it, I would add a little bit of moisture into the matteness of that lipstick, like this one. If Ruby Woo is the consistency of this lipstick, then it would be great. But like I said, this is a matte. Absolutely love it. It has a little bit of moisture, but it's not shiny. It doesn't have luster. It's not glossy. It looks matte, but it's not over drying. That's what I really love about this thing. Like, I love it. You need it. Go get it. I'm just gonna get this other MAC lipstick out of the way, and it is MAC's Candy Yum Yum. I wore this in one of my recent videos, and it is my go-to hot pink over the top lipstick. If I'm wearing hot pink, I'm wearing this just because it's really, really nice. It is a matte lipstick as well. Can you tell I like the trend of MAC matte lipsticks? That's just my thing. And basically this is what it looks like. A very, very vibrant. If you want to sheer it out, you definitely can, or you can wear it full on in your face. Alright, we're getting down to the wire here. Next up is a NYX Butter Gloss. Absolutely love the formula of the NYX Butter Glosses. They are very buttery, hydrating, and moisturizing. Everything I absolutely love in a lipstick. And this one is in the shade Sweet Tart, and I can describe this as being a really pretty rosy lip color. And basically, this is what the pigmentation looks like. As you can see, it is not as vibrant as it is in the tube on the hand, and that is something that I like. I can definitely apply this lipstick, you know, without a mirror if I want to just put it on and go out the door, give my lips a little bit of color. Perfect for the spring on the go every day. But if you do want to build it up to a more full coverage, you definitely can by just kind of rubbing it back and forth like this. So basically, if you do swatch it over your lips multiple times, you will get this consistency on the lips. But that is not something I like to do. I like to wear it very sheer, give my lips a little bit of color, and out the door I go. Next is another NYX Butter Gloss, and this particular butter gloss I hauled not too long ago, and it is the NYX Hot Tamale Lipstick, and it is a orange color, because you guys know orange is just all the rave in the springtime. Everyone loves it, everyone's wearing it, and this isn't a particular color that I would wear every single day in the spring, but certain days in the spring when I want to be a little bit more springish, I guess, I would pop this baby on. Very, very nice. The consistency is amazing. Here we go. Stila Stay All Day Liquid Lipstick in Besso. This is a red color, and red is just a all year around color for me. I wear it in the spring, summer, winter, fall, any time of the year, because red is always in. It's never gonna go out of style. Absolutely love the consistency of this. I have it in a sample size, and I'm definitely going to pick up more in the regular size formulas, containers, whatever. But basically, when you put it on, it comes on very liquidy, and then when you actually blend it out with the doFit applicator, it kind of dries to a matte finish. So it dries to a matte lipstick finish. It's definitely not moisturizing, it's not hydrating, nothing like that, but I definitely love the finish of the lipstick, the color, the pigmentation. It's awesome. The next lip color for the spring season for me is the Maybelline Color Sensational Elixir Lipsticks, and I have been loving the one in Violet. And basically, it is a very vibrant, you probably can't even tell from the two, but it is a very vibrant lip color. And basically what I kind of perceive it as is that somebody took a lipstick, smashed it up, and put it into a tube in a glossy form. And basically that's exactly what it is. This is what it looks like on the hand right here. Very, very pigmented. This is the most pigmented gloss I have ever seen, and it's awesome. It definitely feels really, really nice on the lips. I can't even really explain it. It's not drying. It doesn't dry to a matte finish. It's definitely glossy all the way throughout, and it has a okay staying power. When I eat something, obviously the gloss, it's gonna run off, but it's absolutely fabulous. I absolutely love the color pigmentation, the color, everything about it is gorgeous. Definitely for my skin tone and other skin tones as well. Last but not least is my OCC Lip Tart in Femme. Is that how you say it? Femme? Femme. And it is just this pretty kind of like bubblegum pink color. Really, really do love it. It's very, very subtle. Different from any of the other lipsticks I've shown you. It's just a true baby pink color. If you do have a lighter skin tone than mine, then it may wash you out a little bit, because I kind of feel sometimes it washes me out if I don't line it with a lip liner. But otherwise, I've really, really been loving this. A little bit does go a long way. These OCC Lip Tarts are extremely pigmented, extremely vibrant, depending on what colors you get. So be careful. You don't want to be walking around like Oompa Loompa or anything like that, but I absolutely love it. Keep in mind that if you are going to use OCC Lip Tarts, you have to apply the clear gloss underneath, so that way the actual color doesn't seep into the cracks and crevices of your lips, because we don't want that. Not cute. Alright guys, so that basically wrapped up this whole video. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it, and if you did, give it a big thumbs up. And also, don't forget to check out Bianca's video. I'm going to link it here, and I'm also going to link it in the description box down below. If you do check it out, let her know I sent you, vice versa, you know, all that stuff. And I will be sure to see you guys in my next video. Bye.